There is a saying that goes, each inch of the Chinese territory is covered by blood for the millions of Chinese who died during the war of resistance against the Japanese aggression. It all started on September 18, 1931. Japanese troops destroy a railway in the northeastern Chinese city of Shenyang, and they blame China for the move. They use it as a pretext to invade and occupy China over the next 14 years. 6 years later, gunshots in Beijing at the Lugo Bridge or the Marco Polo Bridge mark Japan's full-scale invasion. This made China the first country to be invaded by fascist states in the Second World War. And China was the first to fight back.
I think the thing for people outside China to understand is that no country suffered more in the Second World War than China.
The first major clash between the two forces was recorded in the Battle of Shanghai. China was battling a stronger enemy. At that time, Japan was far more superior in air power. Although China tried its best to counter Japan's air force, its planes were of inferior quality. The battle lasted 3 months, and China was at the losing end, with nearly 300,000 soldiers dead. But the resistance efforts defeated the Japanese plan to take all of China in 3 months.
在这个过程中，他又跟我来说，他说，这个这次出征呢，可能死骨都找不到，他是这个做好了牺牲的准备的。After
taking Shanghai, the Japanese soldiers continued to move inland. They captured the Chinese capital of Nanjing in December 1937. The subsequent 6 weeks of Nanjing massacre saw mass murder and rape, which killed more than 300,000 Chinese.
把我爸爸打死在地下，倒在地下。可怜妈妈听到爸爸死了，妈妈就出来看爸爸。妈妈也被他打一下，妈妈也打死。可怜的妈妈倒在爸爸怀里头。
A turning point appeared in the Battle of Wuhan. Around 300,000 Japanese soldiers and over 1 million Chinese forces faced off. After the Battle of Wuhan, the war came into a stage of strategic stalemate, but the cost was huge. About 400,000 Chinese forces died. In December 1941, Japan attacked Pearl Harbor, the Pacific War broke out. 2 years later, China signed the Cairo Declaration with the US and Britain. The document cemented China's status as one of the four Allied great powers in the World Anti-Fascist War.
China managed to tie down hundreds of thousands of Japanese troops while the United States invaded the Pacific. So the most important role I would say that China made, or its most important function in the Second World War, is simply not to surrender to a foreign invader.
On August 15, 1945, Japan announced its unconditional surrender. The move also marked the end of World War II. When China began its war of resistance, it was up against two-thirds of Japan's land forces and much of its naval and air forces. Over 35 million Chinese soldiers and civilians made the ultimate sacrifice.
By having China participate in that, that was given some concrete justification. And I think it also made clear that this war was not going to be a race war. Japan tried to turn World War II into a war between Asians against Westerners, or Asians against imperialists, or, you know, Asian people against white people. By including China on the Allied side, that argument just could not be sustained.
China has designated September 3rd as the country's victory day of the Chinese People's War of Resistance against the Japanese aggression. The government said the aim is to commemorate the sacrifices made in the war while avoiding a replay of the catastrophes.